Okay, so this is our new walk-in enclosures. This is one of many. As you see here, we got a whole row of these enclosures going up, one right after another. When we're done, we'll have a total of 9 going all the way down the line. And then we'll have a 10th one inside here that'll be a smaller one. I won't bother showing that to you right now. But so we're gonna have basically 9 enclosures just like this, same dimensions and everything. And you see they're nice and wide. Each one of them are gonna have their own little swimming pool that they can swim in. We got a 100-gallon cattle trough for their swimming pool. They've got pipes they can play in. And branches they can climb on. These branches lead up to their nest boxes, of course. And since this is where all the young mink are, there's multiple nest boxes, but obviously in places where we'll just have individual mink, we'll just put one nest box. One thing you'll notice is everything's off the ground, except for, of course, the swimming pool. Can't really lift that off the ground very easily. It's gonna be so heavy. But these pipes, we don't have them just on the ground. We've got them up suspended. We've got all the tree suspended. That's so that we could easily clean it out with a power washer or push broom. If you notice the frame of the barn here and here, there's a gap. So right here, there's about a 1/2-inch gap underneath it. What that allows is for us to power wash all of the waste outside of the enclosure. And then in the back, there's a little gutter area where we can then sweep it up and clean it up from there. But we just go through the power washer and a push broom and wash it all out. And as you see, they've got all kinds of little tree branches to climb in. They can climb around on the branches. They've got pipes to run through. And it just gives them great opportunity to get some exercise and mental stimulation while they're still in their enclosure. So one thing you'll notice is there's a space in between the wire. There's about 1.5 inches, 2 inches between the wire panels, so the mink can't fight through the wire and harm each other. They could be in opposite cages and not get a hold of each other. If it was just a single sheet of wire, they could get a hold of each other's toes or tongues or whatever and harm each other through the wire. Okay, you guys ready to eat? Come follow me. Here you go.
So one thing I've done with this pool is I've turned it into a enclosure. So I rotate through what mink are spending their day in the pool enclosure, essentially. So they've got a little nest box. I'm gonna be mounting that up in the tree later, but for now I just got it on the ground. And the mink, this is Mr. Spot, get to rotate and trade off being able to spend 12 hours in the pool. And then I rotate it to another mink. So every 12 hours, they get 12 hour shifts of being in here, rotating through all the mink. So they all get the opportunity to be in here for 12 hours at a time and use this as an additional enclosure to the ones that they currently have. I've had a few people asking about Lammy. Here's little Miss Lammy sitting here in the corner. And this is Lammy's boyfriend. His name's Pinky. And we're hoping to get some baby lambs out of Lammy this coming spring. If you guys remember, she is a dairy sheep. So in order for us to provide us milk, she needs to have babies. We tried last year, but her boyfriend did not perform. Little Mr. Pinky's been doing a lot better than her boyfriend from last year. And this little guy, he's just, he's owned by a friend. He'll be going back in about a week, as he's already performed his duties once. And we'll leave them together long enough that they can potentially perform them a second time when she comes into heat again here in a few days. So, we'll give her twice two opportunities to get pregnant rather than just one, if that makes any sense. But Pinky was doing his job just wonderfully. So hopefully we'll have some little sheep next year, and Lammy will produce us some milk. That's the hope. So yeah, guys, I am super excited about MinkLand and all the improvements we're making. It's been a lot of work, and we still have a lot of work left to do. Super excited about the size and quality of our enclosures that we're building. It's a pretty decent expense and effort on our part, but it's so worth it. These mink are just amazing little animals to me, and they've really been a blessing in my life, and I want to make sure I'm a blessing in theirs in giving them the best lives possible and the best enclosures possible. And man, I'm just thrilled to be able to share this with you guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Hope you enjoyed seeing the different enclosures we're building and additions to MinkLand. And appreciate you guys watching. Anyway, thanks for watching, guys. We'll show you more next time.